So welcome students. Today we are going to discuss about the drug excipients in food fraction, that is M.Pharm first semester. Okay, so first I introduce myself, Chaturvedi Sharma, assistant professor, department of pharmacy, Assam Downtown University. So today we are going to discuss about the drug excipient in food fraction. So these are the content, that is introduction, drug excipients interaction, importance of these studies, the mechanism of drug excipients interaction, and analytical techniques that is used to detect the drug excipients compatibility. So first come with the first introduction. So what is pharmaceutical excipients? It is the excipients are pharmaceutically inactive substance formulated alongside the API of the medicine to impact specific qualities of. So excipients are not, that is the product that is used for the that is used with the API, that is active pharmaceutical API, but they do not have any therapeutic or pharmacological value. Okay, so these are used with it to create the formulation regimen. Okay? So whatever formulation we are required, as per our requirement, we are adding the excipients. So simply example, if we are preparing 500 mg paracetamol tablet, okay, if the tablet quantity, when you are practically going to weigh the paracetamol tablet, the tablet of the paracetamol may be 650 mg or more than 650 or 670 mg. Now why? Because we know that the paracetamol 500 mg, it should be 500 mg of paracetamol only, but no. So it contains 500 mg paracetamol and other 150 to 170 mg, these are the excipients. So what is the role of excipients? We are going to discuss here, that provide the bulk of the formulation. Okay, so it provides the bulk of the formulation, it is called as a filler. Okay, so it is also used as a protect and support, enhance the stability of the formulation. Okay, to enhance the stability of the formulation, we are using the excipients. And it improves the bioavailability of the drug. So these are the main roles of excipients. So drug excipients interaction. So simply, if we are talking about the drug excipients interaction, why it is occurs? It is occurs because all are the chemicals. Because chemicals are different properties they have. Okay, when it will mix with each other, it may show some interactions. Okay. So we have to concern about when we are going to formulate the formulation, we have to concern about that. It should not be any interaction occurs in the formulation of any dosage forms. Okay. So it may affect the bioavailability, it may affect the stability, and various factors it may affect. So in terms of drug excipients interaction, drug substances are usually in intimate contact with the excipients. Okay. When I am already give the example, when you are going for the preparation of paracetamol tablet, it not only the paracetamol 500 mg, it also contains the other excipients, that means other chemicals also, like binders, fillers, diamines, okay, disintegrating agents, okay. So all are different ingredients are there. So it is directly contact with the API, okay. Although these are pharmacologically inert, and they can undergo chemical and physical interaction with the drug substance under favorable condition. This interaction can lead the instability resulting in the formulation of new entities. So when we are using different excipients, different chemicals to formulate a different formulation, okay, if it is interact with each other, we cannot get a stable formulation. So to get a stable formulation, so we have to concern about the drug excipient interaction. So already you noted the excipients are pharmacologically inert. Okay, it is did not have any pharmacological activity. They did not cure any disease. They are only used as a helper. And simply you can say that they are used as a helper for the formulation purpose. Okay. So what is the importance of these studies? So main importance are we are pointing out here, okay, to find how compatible an excipient with a, okay, that means when we are going for formulation, I've already given the example, if you are preparing the paracetamol tablet, So paracetamol tablet 500 mg tablet is a API, that is active pharmaceutical ingredient. So when we are going for preparing the paracetamol tablet, okay, so what kind of excipients, that is binding agent, filler, diluent, okay, disintegrating agent, lubricating agent, or maybe it is flavoring agent, all should be compatible with the active pharmaceutical ingredient. That means all should be compatible with the paracetamol. If the paracetamol, we are preparing paracetamol tablet, then paracetamol should be compatible with the all excipients. That means they do not have to show any interaction with each other. If they show the interaction, then it may be unstable. The formulation becomes unstable. So when we are taking the unstable formulation, it cannot react, it cannot show the proper bioavailability. So next, maximize the stability of the process. When it is, I am already told that when it is compatible, it shows the maximum stability. Okay, then do not have impact on the stability of the drug stability and API stability. So drug stability is depend on the API stability. Okay, when it is did not show any interaction, then API stability is for the longer time. It shows the positive stability for the API. Next, determination the list of excipients that can be used in the final dosage. So drug excipients interaction, we need to what is the main motto going for the study of the drug excipients interaction. Okay, when we are going for a novel formulation, okay, new formulation, we have to know that what we have to add in the formulation. Okay, along with the API, what we can use if they have some interaction. Because see, lots of binding agents, lots of fillers, lots of disintegrating agents are there. That is commercially available or naturally available. Okay, so we cannot take all the ingredients each other. We cannot take all the ingredients because they are some may be compatible with the API or some may not be compatible with the API. Okay, so for the determination, proper determination, for we are preparing the paracetamol tablet, we are using starch as a binder, okay, or starch as a filler. Because why we know that? After going to the proper study of this excipients compatibility. If it is compatible, then we are accepted, starch is a filler, we can use it in the preparation of paracetamol tablets. Because why? Because starch is not so many interaction with the paracetamol. That is the main reason. Next point, help you avoid surprise problem during formulation process. See, same thing, if you don't know the chemical properties of the particular excipients, it may show some difficulties in the formulation process. Okay, for the new formulation, it shows various difficulties. So, to avoid the surprise problems during the formulation, we are going for the reformulation or drug excipients compatibility study. Okay. These studies are the part of the pre-formulation study, and this study data is essential for IND submission. Okay, for the new drug implementation, for the new drug invention, okay, we have to go for the pre-formulation. So, drug excipients compatibility study is also a part of the pre-formulation study. So, this is about the drug excipients compatibility study, that is the importance of the study. Okay, in the next class, we are going to the different type of drug excipients compatibility. Okay, thank you so much.